Ask Ken Kraetzer for Sons of American Legion Radio, rallypoint.com. I have a chance to talk with the defensive coordinator of Army football, as Jay Bateman. And Jay, good scrimmage. You got a lot of experienced players on your defense. How'd that look tonight?
I was proud to see some of those guys come back. Some of them have been banged up for the last couple days, and especially in the secondary, see some of those kids come out and really communicate well. We had to do some tricky stuff at them. I thought they did a really nice job.
And you really got a solid core of linebackers again with James Nautical and Cole Christensen inside and Ken Brinson. And then you've got a new player added to the lineup, Chandler Ramirez, this year. How has that group worked together so far this season?
No, I mean, we're excited about those guys. You know, Chandler last year played about 100 snaps, and mostly on pass downs, and we knew we had a kid who was going to really shine as a senior. He's done a really great job with Coach Hess in our weight room. We're excited about him. And, you know, Kenny and James and Cole have played a lot of football now, especially Kenny. He feels like he's been here about 7 years now, so.
Well, I know he started as a freshman, and what a great student he is on top of that. How about tell us a little bit about your frontline players. You've got Ray Wright. You've got Cordell Davis up front. Yumi Amatuga at left end, Patterson, Evice, and Jacob Covington, some of the players. Tell us about your up front guys.
Sure. You know, I think Yumi Amatuga and Ray Wright both started last year. Both did a really nice job. They're bigger. They're stronger. I'm really excited to see those two kids as seniors really, really be special players for us. Adrees Patterson's a sophomore who we think the world of. Really had a great spring. You know, as a freshman, we said, man, we got a player here. We think he's going to really come along. He has. I think Jacob Covington has done an unbelievable job. We signed him as an inside linebacker. Now he's 275. Really powerful, really athletic. And then I think Rod Stoddard and Cordero Davis are both nose guards that we've got a lot of faith in that are going to be good players. And I think Kwabena Bonsu is a young freshman who's going to be really talented. I think Jacob Ellington's doing a really good job. So I think the thing we have at D-line right now, in addition to having some older kids that are really, really veteran guys, is a really, really good crop of young kids that can provide some depth.
And your defensive backfield, you've got some experience. Jalen Sharp, Max Regan, Jalen McClinton, and a few other newcomers. And last year you had a lot of injuries, but you've had the depth and some young players who really came to play when they were given the opportunity. How do you feel about your defensive secondary?
I think what's exciting back there is there's so many kids that have played that you feel like, hey, look, we can really maybe rotate some guys and really, you know, do some stuff with some extra defensive backs in the game, some nickel and dime defense we haven't felt as comfortable doing. So James Gibson's played a lot of football for us. Really excited about him. He's done a great job as a leader. Elijah Riley, obviously, is a really talented kid. And I think Max Regan, Jalen McClinton, Cam Jones at safety are really, really coming along. And I think Javari Boudreaux had a really good camp. So I'm excited about that group of kids, too.
Very good. Maybe for some of the fans, man, I know your career and coaching. Maybe just tell us a little bit about some of your path, you know, getting here to West Point, and you certainly have led a terrific defensive unit here.
I appreciate that. You know, Coach Munkin and I got connected when he was at Georgia Southern, and he offered me a job, and I wasn't very smart. I said no, and I ended up at Ball State University in the MAC. And I told my wife if Jeff ever called again, I was going. So when he got this job, he called me, and we had some conversation. I was really excited, really fortunate to be here. And, you know, Ken, I love coaching here. We got great kids. We got an unbelievable head coach, and I think we have a really special season.
And so you've had some really terrific linebackers mature in the program and really lead the defense. Is there a key to your philosophy in running a defensive unit at this level?
I think here we're going to always have good linebackers. I think the kids that play linebacker, that body type, that type of kid is attracted to West Point. And I think we've kind of built the defense around that group. I think what's really, really cool now is we're starting to get some D linemen that are really, really real players. John Voigt was a real player. Ray Wright's a real player. Wumi Oyatuga is a real player. You know, and now I think the secondary is really caught up too. And so I think the key here, we play really hard. We play really physical. Coach Munkin demands that. We go up against the best running offense in the world every day in practice. You know, Coach Davis got those guys coming at us. And I think when we get ready to go play a game, all of a sudden it's a little bit easier. So I'm excited to see our kids cut it loose this year.
Hey, sometimes the coaches who come to West Point remark about what a special place it is and some of the VIP visitors that you meet. What's been special for you about coaching here at West Point?
I think the number one thing is the players. You know, I think just the quality of the young men. That's part of the reason I came here. You know, my family, when you coach college football, your players are part of your family. And I think to have those kids around as role models and leaders to demonstrate to my kids what a great American is supposed to look like has been great. I think that's the best thing. But yeah, I mean we've met some really cool people. You know, the superintendents have been awesome. You know, man. So I think every single day I'm in awe when I work here.
Jay Bateman, great to chat, and looking forward to this time Friday night next week down at Duke. And best wishes as you start the season.
Thanks, Ken. I really appreciate it.
It's Ken Kraetzer for Sons of American Legion Radio and Rally Point at the United States Military Academy.